Lives and lives on from old Charlottetown on down of the big wagon they call the truckster. The car, if I said, should have been given up for dead, but she drove on with all she could muster. The Buick was the pride of Drew McDonald's eye, coming back from his mother's to Bangor. He didn't have a clue that on I-95 Drew and the truckster were headed for danger. On board 26,000 tons more than the Buick LeSabre weighed empty. Playing some tunes was a bone to be chewed when the flames of the truckster went burning. When homecoming came, they would head to Mount Dade and they'd leave fully loaded for Sackville. Smoked till they were sick, then they tried to drag Nick. He'd say, fuck it, I'll take the train back to Wolfville. The brakes sometimes fail, but like riding on rails through the corner of any intersection. Every man knew, as was told them by Drew, it had four-wheel posi track suspension. The speedometer dials were all listed in miles. The odometer read 200,000. But that afternoon came and so did the flames in the face of a hurricane west wind. Of the Buick LeSabre. The passersby said Drew was lucky not to be dead, cause to drive an old car is a gamble. The police report said he'd have made Winterport if the car had contained less flammable. As a junker, but all that remains is the rear license plate and the 6-foot-long polished chrome bumper. The legend lives on from old Charlottetown on down of the big wagon they call the truckster. The Buick, they said, she will never be dead in the minds of the many who love her.